Hello, vinyl community, it's Matt here again, and we have an unboxing video today. So for those of you who saw my fairly recent video about the new room setup, you may remember that I got a subwoofer, which is back here. You can kind of see it down there. Well, it's been acting up a little bit, so it was fine for the first, you know, week, 2 weeks, whatever, and gradually, when there's no music playing, I hear static coming through it, but it's not all the time. And it went on for a few days, and I ended up ordering a new subwoofer, which we get unboxed right here. And then it stopped acting up. But this was a really good deal. I saw it on eBay and jumped on it. So it's the same subwoofer that I got back there, but this is the newer model. So I'm thinking that, I don't know, with the old one, I don't know if there's just maybe a loose solder joint, in which case I thought about opening it up and having a look around, but honestly, while I may own a soldering iron, that doesn't really mean I know what I'm doing. So I thought, well, I'll keep playing this one for now, it's fine, and then I'll look around. And sure enough, this model came up, and with shipping, it ended up being less than half, I think, what I paid for the older one. So hopefully the condition's good. I mean, the seller said that it was in good condition, but you know, I don't know, but it looks well packaged, hopefully. It did take them a while to ship it. It took like a week, and the seller and I, you know, so I gave it a week, and then I just sent them a message asking for a tracking number, and they said, oh, you know, here's the tracking number, but it did say that it could take a week to ship. And I've looked at the listing again. I don't think it says that, unless I just missed it, but it doesn't matter. Because by the time they did ship it, it got here within like 4 or 5 days, so pretty good. Although it was coming from California, which is where I'm at, so it ended up being quicker than it might otherwise have been, I suppose. So we're gonna open this up, and you know, the plan is to use exactly the same way as the other one. I'm not necessarily expecting it to sound any different, but I guess we'll find out, won't we? I do have a way I'm going to test it, because if I want to put it, you know, switch it out right away, well, I've probably got to empty out that set of cubes that's right there, because it's going to be too heavy to move it otherwise. So I've got to empty all the records out of that, just so I can pull the cubes back enough to get the plug out, because it's wired in, whereas this one has a, you know, like a, I don't know, a breakaway plug, like a standard S type plug. The older model does not. So let's keep opening this, and you know, I was liking the way it was sounding. It's just unfortunate about the static. And I tried having it on with nothing else on as well when it was acting up. So I turned the amp off completely. There's no audio source going to it, and I tried unplugging all of the inputs as well, and it was still making the noise. I think I possibly tried unplugging the outputs as well to the speakers, and it's still doing it. And it's almost like, do you remember the sound? It doesn't tend to happen so much anymore, but do you remember the slightly older cell phones when you would hold those next to a speaker and you would get this, you know, like a buzzing staticky sound? It was almost a little bit like that. But like I said, I tried it with everything switched off completely, like no power going to the amp, to anything, and it was still doing it. So then I ordered this one, and then, as I mentioned, suddenly it's been okay for the last week or so. But this will be the amp that I want to use, this newer one, assuming that everything is working well and conditions good. Now, I couldn't see the speaker itself in the listing. I mean, the grill was on, so I'm hoping it's not like squashed in or anything. That would be unfortunate, but okay. What the heck is this? Okay, it's kind of a dirty bag, but that's all right. As long as it's packaged okay. I do see a bunch of like foam in here, which is nice. Okay, I'm not sure how I'm gonna lift this out. I think I'm gonna have to maybe tip it. Let's see. Which I don't really want to do because it's probably putting it upside down, but if we're gentle with it. Here we go. All right. Yeah, it's got like. It's like a bag or something wrapped around it. Oh, it's in a bag, yeah, okay. But it did have, it had this huge, like, foam wraparound in it, so that's nice, it's good, that's good to see. Let's try and take it out of this bag, which looks a bit challenging just by itself. Here we go. Alright. Okay. So, it's gonna need a little bit of a wipe down. But let me turn it over. And there it is. So if you look back there, you can see it really doesn't look much different. But this is a different model. Now, before we get into any of that, we gotta take the grill off and hope that we like what we see. This could be a real short video. If this thing's all squished in, this is gonna be a short one. Let me have a look. Doesn't want to come off. There it comes. Boy, it's on there pretty good. It's coming. I haven't peeked yet. Let's have a look. Looks nice. Look at that. Beautiful. Very nice. Very nice. Let me hold it up. Didn't realize you guys couldn't see it. Okay, cool. So this, I think, is like a woven... I think it's woven fiberglass, which is interesting. I don't remember if they used the same thing for that one, but I'm not sure because the other one is just a black speaker. This one you can actually kind of see the weaves in it, and obviously you can see it's silver. One big difference with this is that the volume control is on the front, so that's more convenient. I haven't got to pull the thing out to change the volume. And if we look on the back. Just brush off a bit of dust right there. Oh, where's the power cable? Okay. For a split second, I thought it wasn't in there, but there's a power cable. You can see it's the kind of the S connector. It's break like a pull-away, breakaway plug type of thing. And so that's a little more convenient as well. And so it uses this... I don't know too much about it. Maybe somebody else will, but it has a logo here. It uses this bash technology, which... I understand it's the reason why it doesn't have like a big radiator grill thing on the back like the older model does. But I'll be using it the same way. We'll be using the high level input, so running directly from the Sony receiver to the high level inputs, and then going from the outputs to the speakers. And I've already got, luckily, this is where I'm glad that I wired the banana plugs a month ago when I first did this, because that'll make it a lot quicker. And so we've got phase switch, mode, on, off, auto. So in terms of the settings, it looks the same as the older model. I think this may have a slightly wider crossover range. Goes from 40 hertz to... LFE, whatever that is. Somebody can tell me. Is that like the dynamic? I don't know. Anyway, but so we're gonna give this a go. Now, I'm not gonna pull everything out of the cube to test it, because if there's a problem with it, then I've just wasted a whole bunch of time. Then I gotta pull all the records back. I gotta put the old subwoofer back. So I'm not doing that. Instead, I'm going to test it. Let me find it using a CD player like this one. This will do. Because this has a line out, so I can hook this up to the line level inputs on here, and I'm gonna hook it up right here. So stay tuned. I will be back in just a minute once we got this thing wired up. We can just make sure that it's working okay. All right, I got it wired up. The power light came out of the back, so that's something. What I'm gonna do here, got our CD player, and I've got a
headphone jack to like a 3.5 mil to RCA cable adapter. And this CD player has both a headphone out, but it also has a line out. So we're gonna use the line out, and we're gonna stick on this because the first song is Ultravox Vienna, which has you know, immediate kind of bass. Do 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 do. You know, I'm not gonna try and sing anymore. But so we're gonna plug this into the line in at the back here. There we go. We're gonna set this to auto. So on auto, it should start as soon as it detects sound coming in. And the crossover, we're just gonna leave in the middle, which is at 120. For the purposes of this test, it doesn't actually matter because we don't have any other audio coming in. So let's push play. I don't know what the volume's at either. Halfway, that's probably fine. Let's try that. Let's see what happens here. Okay. Wow. Now, if I turn the crossover up, you're actually going to hear more of it. Like that. Now, that volume might be too loud. We're going to see, but yeah, you can see this thing vibrate. Look at this. Well, that's good. Looks like it's working. So we turn the volume down. Okay, yep. I don't want to turn it way. I mean, that. I don't know how loud to put it, but. Whoa. Oh, it's getting a lot of the lower frequencies there. Okay. Try another song. What's the next song? Gary Numan, Cars. Let me see if I can find one that's got some good bass on it. Hang on. I mean, I guess it kind of does. But... Okay. Well, it's working well. As far as I can tell. As far as I can tell, it looks good. So, I might let this run for a little bit, break it in. I also brought up some paper towels. I'm gonna just put some water on this just to give it a quick wipe down. And then we're gonna put it in the setup and we're gonna see how it sounds. So I guess stick around. I actually wasn't gonna do this, but now I think about it, what the heck. So I'm gonna take the records out of the cube once I've let this run for like 10 minutes just to make sure there's no unexpected surprises. And then we'll try playing a song. I don't know, last time I played that Ondara song, which I did get a copyright notice for, but it was only banned in two countries. So we might do that one again. It's a good test record, but anyway, stick around. I'm gonna break this in and then we'll be right back. All right, well, I am just gonna test this record again because it's a good basis for comparison since that's the record I used to first test out the old sub. So yeah, Ondara, Spanish Villager number 3. We're gonna crank up the first song, which is An Alien in Minneapolis. Really good song, really good beat to it. And I know that YouTube should allow it. It flags it as being copyrighted, but it still allows it in, like I said, like all but two countries. So, but anyway, it's in, it's set up right over here. There it is, down at the bottom there. So, yeah, let's give it a listen. I think I've fine-tuned it enough where, and actually, you know, it sounded better with the high-level inputs than it did with the low-level with the RCA inputs, funny enough. Not exactly sure why that would be, but anyway, yeah, it sounded pretty good from, I just did a quick test of the same CD I was using and sounded fine to me. So we're gonna test this out and, yeah, let's take a listen to it. Thank you.
All right, sounded pretty good to me. I thought I'd play the whole song this time because the whole reason I didn't last time was because I was concerned that it would get dinged for copyright, which it did anyway, so what the heck? Might as well play the whole thing. I really like the song. So anyway, yeah, it's sounding good. Haven't noticed any of that staticky buzzing yet, so that's a good sign. I mean, I'll keep hold of the other one for a while just in case, since like I said, it did that weird static thing for a few days and then it seemed like it had stopped doing it, but by that point I'd already found that deal on eBay for the new one. So yeah. All right, guys. Thanks as always for watching. I know that this one dragged on a little bit, but hope you still enjoyed it. Always appreciate everybody who watches and who subscribes. And until next time, bye bye.